folks, is it a tough election cycle or what?
Iowa Senator Joni Ernst is feeling the October heat.
It is a tough, tough, tough year. But you know what? I'm going to finish first. Yes.
Yet her reelection is not entirely in her control, with Republican fortunes tied to President Trump.
That's the real terror of this all, is that Trump takes down the whole ticket, the whole Republican side of the Senate.
Mark McAllister voted for Trump 4 years ago. He said he won't do so again.
I think he has been extremely divisive to our people. I use the word despicable, and I do think he's despicable.
Despicable?
Yes.
In Iowa, where Trump won by 9 percentage points, polls now show he's locked in a tight race with Joe Biden. Republican officials are nervously watching the suburbs here as the president's shaky support threatens the GOP Senate majority and Ernst, a once rising party star.
In many ways, she's been a disappointment. She's not been a leader. She's basically parroted what the Trump administration has told her to project.
We caught up with Ernst at a weekend campaign motorcycle ride.
Senator, is President Trump complicating your race?
No, I would say I'm running my own race.
But you are tied to him, which is beneficial, obviously, in some parts of Iowa. But what about the suburbs? Does that complicate your path there?
I think, again, in the suburbs, I've met with suburban women. They're really concerned about law and order, that type of issue. And that actually is an issue that draws them closer to the president.
That is unclear.
This is great.
Her Democratic opponent, Teresa Greenfield, believes other issues are more pressing.
And I will tell you, health care is number one. And certainly during COVID, that has elevated that conversation and very difficult health pandemic coupled with economic crisis, Iowans are concerned for sure.
The question is whether Trump's standing lifts or sinks the ticket in a state he's suddenly fighting to defend.
So we're going to win the great state of Iowa, and it's going to be a historic landslide.
Trump won 93 of Iowa's 99 counties, including 31 that twice voted for President Obama. Jasper County, once home to the Maytag company, is one of them.
He just says it like it is.
Thad Nearmeyer, the Republican county chairman, wasn't initially sold on Trump before he was elected. But now he deeply believes in him and thinks the Trump base is growing.
I used to think, well, he's done it this time, but he always seems like he overcomes that, so I don't even worry about him anymore. What we care about is results.
His Democratic counterpart, Michelle Smith, said too many Democrats were not inspired to vote 4 years ago, which she said won't happen this time.
The ones I know that didn't vote are going to vote for Joe Biden this time because they realize by not voting what we've had to endure the last 3.5 years.